Joe Myers is uniquely credible.
And when I first saw him, I pictured this person wearing a headdress and actually being a chief.
He's calm and he's got a great sense of humor.
He's very knowledgeable, and that's what I like about him.
He's not the first person to say, you know, look at all the wonderful things I've done. He definitely looks at it from this perspective of what more can I do?
Joe's professional trajectory is unorthodox, and I think many people don't know that. He started his career in law enforcement, and you know, there is a dedication to service and justice that really goes back a long ways.
And so I ended up going to Bolt Hall here on this campus, graduated from law school, took a job with the American Indian Lawyer Training Program, and I was able to develop an advocacy training program for tribal courts. There had never been any training for those who practiced in tribal courts. And so the Justice Center was created, and we've gotten involved in other things besides just the justice system. Training social services people, healthcare providers, political folks like people on tribal councils.
The goal of the Justice Center is not to come in and try to fix issues in Indian communities. The goal of the Justice Center is to come in and provide tools and resources for those communities to address their own problems.
So we decided that we were going to develop a conference, and the conference was called For All My Relations. And what we wanted to do was to bring together Indian families for an annual conference where they learn stuff. They learn things about health. They learn things about how to deal with justice, how to deal with environmental justice.
We have model youth tribal councils, and so it's preparing today's youth to be tomorrow's leaders.
What is really important about that conference is the Indian families getting together and exchanging ideas and thoughts intertribally. And talking about their families and what their needs are. So it's one success story that, that we're very proud of.
The California Indian Museum has a unique mission, and it's really to tell the story of California Indian history from a Native perspective.
When the California Indian Museum and Cultural Center was first being developed, I really started seeing Joe a lot and working with him and working with his daughter, Nikki. When they want to talk about a future exhibit, they sort of come in with a different idea of how they'd like to do things, which sometimes for us is like, well, but that's, we don't, usually don't do things that way. But it's been really great because there's a trust that's been built up. And so it's like, okay, that's how they want to do it. Then let's do everything we can to make it work in that way.
Joe's role in the museum is actually the engine behind it, literally. It was his vision from the very beginning. It was his connections that brought about funding, that built staffing, that created programming, that established the networking. So he really is the, you know, the economic professional engine behind the entire operation.
He does a great deal to help us reach our dream, which is to deepen our relationships with the Indian communities in California.
In fact, there is a movement by some tribes.
The class is set up like an actual tribal council, and each one of us has a position. And when Professor Myers asked who wanted to be the chair, I immediately raised my hand.
We all sat like in circle, and we discussed the law, like the topic of the day. And that's where you learn more about the issues. Like, you get to discuss and you actually get to see how complicated it is to come out with like laws that make sense and they're like good for everyone.
The students here at Berkeley keep you tuned in to making sure that you keep up with what's going on around you. You have the opportunity to spark a little interest. And when you've done that and they take up the challenge, you get a lot of satisfaction out of it.
He gave me some of my first opportunities to be an intern and work in Indian country. And I went on to the same law school he did and have followed many similar paths. So if there's someone I can credit, it's probably Joe.
I am really happy that he's got this honor and this opportunity to celebrate, you know, his career and his contributions. And just want everyone to know what a hardworking, good-hearted, compassionate individual he is. And I'm very proud to have him as my father.